Hello guys, welcome to Psychology of Freedom. This time, itatype natin si Denise Laurel. Ang nag-request niyan si Love Anna 2006. So, kay Love Anna 2006, thank you so much for requesting this. Ito na yung request mo, itatype natin si Denise Laurel. So, paano natin siya itatype? Kukunin natin yung cognitive functions niya. FITE user ba siya or TIFE? SINE user ba siya or NISE? Interaction style niya naman, direct ba siya or informative? Responding or initiating? Movement versus control, temperament niya, abstract ba siya or concrete, affiliative or pragmatic, systematic versus interest-based. Excuse me. And then yung last step is, it-track naman natin among the 16 types kung alin talaga yung personality type niya based on the information that we have gathered. So, ayan. Let's start with this video.
And magka-flatmate kami ni Mariel. Hindi pa siya
nag-artista
dito. Rodriguez.
Oh!
Yeah! That was her first ever show. Commercial model siya nun. I mean, very popular.
This is what she is doing. Ito yung mga ginagawa niya dati. Blah, blah, blah. Extroverted sensing. Other people's experiences.
Commercial model and model. But that was the first time she took an acting job. And it was international. And then after that, she became an MTV VJ.
This is what she did, blah, blah, blah. She became this. Extroverted sensing.
Here, I would do some VJ work over there. And then I went back to acting. Tapos nung bumalik na kami dito. Tapos naging actress na rin siya dito. So sobrang cool. Madami talaga akong natutunan kay Mariel. And yun, sobrang saya kasi action yung ginagawa namin. So lahat ng stunts na gustong gawin, ginagawa ko.
Action yung ginagawa namin. Shared experience, extroverted sensing.
Talaga yung mga takbuhan na may explosion sa likod. Mahuli ka, tapos may kaaway ako na mga lalaki na twice my size. You know, sobrang cool.
In fairness, nagawa mo rin pala, hindi sa TV yung action-action, kundi talagang sa international pa pala.
Yeah, pero wala pang ano nun, wala pang Twitter, wala pang social media, and...
Wala pang ginto, nag-initiate siya doon.
Hindi siya masyado na-hype. Sayang kasi dalawa yung...
Hindi siya masyadong na-hype. Sayang. Ito yung outcome. This is the outcome of what we did. Control.
Pinay doon. And sobrang out of 500 women from Asia, 2 Filipinas were taken.
Ang taray, no? Iba din pala. International audience para dito, no?
Extroverted sensing pa din kasi this is what happened. Diba?
Oh, perfect. Sana mapanood natin ito. Ito next.
Oh my gosh, maging sino ka man. Best actor yung first on-screen kiss ko.
Paano pinagandaan yung eksena with Lloydie na yan? First on-screen kiss mo?
I think the set kasi was very professional. I was scared to death of our director. Si Derek F.
Paano yung paghahanda na ginawa? Yung answer niya seems more on of interest base kasi parang wala siyang, kapag kasi systematic kasi, this is what I did, step 1, step 2, step 3, pero siya wala siyang ganon. So most probably mas interest based siya.
Well, because it was my first time working with him and he has a different style, a style which I wanted to learn and master. But I was so nervous because syempre, yung mga kasama ko doon, kilala na siya. And they were all established, amazing actors already. Bea, Lloydie, dami sila.
They were all established, amazing actors, extroverted feeling, all about other people.
Kuya Smokey Mananoto was there also. And I felt a lot of pressure to really do my best kasi I wanted to give him what he really wanted. So I was so nervous.
I wanted to give him introverted intuition, but extroverted intuition din. She still has extroverted intuition, but maybe mas mababa lang sa cognition niya yun.
Throughout the whole shoot, but I remember soaking up so much also from Lloydie and really watching him. Alam ko, the first ever eksena we had was the first time I ever got starstruck my whole entire life. We were doing a scene that was very intimate.
We were doing this, shared experiences, that's extroverted sensing.
Nasa simbahan kami, nagdadasal siya.
And nagdadasal siya, ito yung ginagawa niya, blah, 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 extroverted sensing.
Naglalabas siya ng sama ng loob at dapat ipapakita ko sa mata ko na in love ako sa kanya, pero sa harapan niya, hindi niya alam, nakikinig lang ako being a best friend and magbibigay ako ng advice. Pero sa sobrang galing niya, kunyari ikaw si Lloyd, nakikinig ako sa mga lines niya, lines ko na, nakatulala ako sa kanya, sa galing niya. So syempre, I felt so bad we had to do the scene again. He was so good.
I felt so bad. Introverted feeling.
I was blown away by his acting and I forgot that may lines din pala ako.
And I was blown away by him. He's an amazing actor. Extroverted feeling pa din.
Na-starstruck ako ng The Oras. And I was so quiet on set because I was really just happy to be there and in awe of everyone.
I'm in awe of everyone. Extroverted feeling. Everyone's so great. And also may pagkocontrol kasi sabi niya, di ba, yung outcome, yung nangyari, natulala lang siya, hindi siya nakapag-act.
And then, nasa Baseco kami. So,
nasa Baseco kami, extroverted sensing, shared experiences.
Nobody was afraid that, because I look social, that I wouldn't be able to hang out. Kasi yung Baseco dati noon, wala pang cemento yung floor.
Ito yung na-observe ko sa environment.
Tapos, yung CR namin was just a hole in...
For sure, S-E-N-I, user siya. Check pa tayo ng iba pang interview.
Called you on the phone and they said, hey, we found this going on.
Well, they can see it when you do an ultrasound. And also you got to do some blood work and sugar tests and stuff like that and your thyroid. And they do the whole thing. And the thing is, I never really did that before.
This is what they do. This is what they do.
For like a full body thing. And then I even went to Singapore and did a full body checkup, and then they also found a cyst in my breast and my lymph node, and basically I found out that I was such a sister. Like, I
very focused on the outcome. Although sinabi niya yung journey towards that outcome, ito yung ginawa niya, pumunta siya sa Singapore, nagpa-test, blah blah blah, pero this is the outcome. Ito yung pinaka-importante, yung outcome.
Had cysts in my breast, my lymph nodes, my ovaries, and the back of my head, and so I was just like, yo, God, like, let's take care of my life. The one in my breast and my lymph node, that was a major stress for me.
Like, what was your biggest concern of what you thought it was?
It wasn't more so concern about me and my body. It was more concern about Bookie's future.
Because you thought this was life threat.
I'm more concerned about other people than myself. As all extroverted feeler does, especially high FE users. Mas concerned nila yung ibang tao kasi sa sarili nilang feelings.
Threatening?
Yeah, because they were like, it could be cancerous. So they
did say it could be cancer.
Yeah, so that was around a little before your thing.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
You did it?
Before your thing, that's initiating. Nag-initiate siya ng bagong topic doon.
Get a confirmation at that
no,
time.
No, so we
they,
did
it. They said
yeah.
It could be cancer.
I went to Singapore and I got all my tests, and then I had to go back home to shoot.
And during this time, you didn't know what you had.
Yeah, so they said there was a possibility we got to do a biopsy, but I had to do the biopsy here.
Very direct siya. Kung ano yung tinanong sa kanya, straight to the point yung answer.
In the Philippines. So in between shoots, I went to go do the biopsy.
I know what that's like. I think one of the most difficult times in going through any health scare is the waiting game when you don't know what it is. Because for me, yeah, I've been there where they're like, oh, it can possibly be cancer, you know? So that's a really scary
time.
Dude,
that was the one. Because not scared for myself, but I was like, shit, I'm such an irresponsible parent. I don't have that much savings.
Very self-deprecating behavior. F-E-T-I. Extroverted feeling.
For him and his future. So I was like, oh my God, like, what am I gonna do? Like, blah, blah, blah. Not scared about.
Very focused on the future and what can happen. That's a little bit abstract.
Any pain or anything that I would have to go through. Because
you weren't scared of your own pain or like.
Not scared of her own pain. Kasi nga, mababa yung introverted sensing niya sa cognition niya. Kasi all body sensations is more attached to introverted sensing.
Of dying. I mean, no, for yourself.
So I've never been afraid of death.
Super direct.
I can't relate.
But when I became a parent,
death is so scary.
But when I became a parent, that's when I became scared of death.
Okay.
Outcome focus.
So because... you weren't afraid of death before you had a kid, but now that you have a kid, now you're afraid of death.
Yeah, just because I want to make sure he's.
You should want to be there for him.
This is my intention. I want this introverted intuition.
Dude, like, that's my person. Like, I gotta take care of everybody. If I take care of my homies, like, with my whole heart, what more, my kid? I
haven't. Why are you not a?
Kind of affiliative, taking care of other people. That's parang high FEU, sir.
Afraid of death for yourself.
I guess I've always been like pretty.
Check patay na iba pang interview. Check natin. And make sure natin yung temperament niya. Kasi so far, get na natin yung cognitive functions niya, interaction style, but temperament, medyo konti pa lang yung tick marks.
I think since your parents, and when you were younger, would always understand you,
A little bit of context with this video, meron nanghihingi sa kanila ng advice about a situation wherein his mother is going back to her old habits of addiction to a certain chemical, to a certain prohibited, alam nyo na.
I think it's time for you to understand your mom now. And, you know, she kind of, you being family and her being your mother, you have to pick her up this time. And it's not...
You have to pick her up. This is what you should do. That's extroverted sensing, making other people do things, and then may pagka-affiliative. She's your mom, ganyan.
Just in payback for all the times that she picked you up or took care of you.
Not just a payback, but this is the right thing to do. That's affiliative.
I just think that you're angry because you love her and you...
I think, introverted thinking, this is what I think.
Care about her, right? Am I right? And you're disappointed.
She kind of like projected. I think you're angry because you're disappointed and you really care about her. She projected herself onto the other person. So still extroverted feeling.
And I just don't want to have a shitty life again. Yeah, that's why.
I understand that. So what you do now is you have to set all those negative feelings aside.
You have to do this, you have to do that, extroverted sensing, and directive, kind of like, parang, it can come off as bossy, but directive kasi yung language na straight to the point, walang parang paligoy-ligoy. So this is what you should do.
For the moment, and focus on what has to be done. I think maybe you're going to have to take a second job or something, but you need to her that treatment because it's just going to be a vicious cycle over and over again. And
it's going to be a vicious cycle over and over again. Abstract. And then may pagka low NE, extroverted intuition, kasi ba, pessimistic yung extroverted intuition niya, di ba? Even kanina nung sinabi niyang ano na mangyayari sa future ng anak niya, something like that.
And I think there are like out clinics like you can go to on weekends, or she can still work, and then there are like appointments that she has to go.
I think introverted thinking, most of the time, kapag ang tao, more on, ang language na is I think, not I feel like, most of the time, TI user yung ba kayo, but not always.
But the treatment, like Mo said, is very important. And
it's mandatory.
Yeah.
Listen.
She hasn't talked to me and haven't said sorry or something.
You, of course, Bird, come on. Don't leave the decisions up to an...
You can't. It's like trying to fight someone that's drunk. You won't get anything out of them. Like,
go make the first...
You won't get anything out of them. That's abstract. And then, extroverted intuition, pessimistic.
Steps.
You have to be the bigger person.
You care about it.
You have to be the bigger person. You have to do the right thing. Affiliative.
Yes. All right. Show her that you care about it. Make the first steps. Approach her. Talk to her.
So I think okay na to. Sure na tayo na cognitive functions niya. FETI user. SENI. Interaction style niya. Direct. Initiating control. One of the in charge types. Temperament niya. Abstract. Affiliative. Interest based. So tingnan natin yan dito. Direct initiating control. Dun siya sa first row. So tanggal na yung third. Second and fourth row. And sabi natin, di ba, FETISENI user siya. So, nasa NFJ-STP quadro siya. So, tanggalin ESTJ, ENTJ. And sabi natin, abstract siya and affiliative. So, she cannot be an ESTP. So, tanggal na rin yung ESTP. So, she can only be an ENFJ, also known as the mentor. So, madami-dami na tayo na type na mentors. Ayan, very obvious. FE hero, SE child, wanting to make other people comfortable all the time. So, yan ang mga ENFJ, also known as the mentor. Ang ka-personality type niya is si Kelly Clarkson, si Regine Velasquez, sino pa? Si... Meron pa ako isang tinipe, si Angeline Quinto. They are all ENFJs. Even si Josh Cullen pala is an ENFJ. So, ayun lang. Thank you so much for requesting this. Very much appreciated. From Love Anna 2006. And may nakatama. So, sa nakatama, thank you for participating and good job. We're getting so much better at typing people. So, ayan, if you have any comments, suggestions, violent reactions, comment nyo lang sa comment section below. So, thank you so much for listening and watching. See you sa next video.